In August 2017, in the face of ethnic cleansing, nearly 1 million Rohingya minorities fled from the Rakhine state of Myanmar and entered Bangladesh seeking safety and shelter. As an immediate neighbor, Bangladesh responded to the call of humanity and provided them with food, shelter, and protection. This timely and courageous gesture of the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Her Excellency Sheikh Hasina, stabilized the region from a catastrophe. She visited Cox's Bazar camps on 12 September 2017 and expressed her deep sorrow and sympathy for these helpless and homeless people. Pope Francis, UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson, Turkey Prime Minister Binali Yildirim, head of UNHCR Filippo Grandi, and other honorable heads of states and international organizations visited Bangladesh and conveyed their strong support towards Bangladesh's position. Now, more than 1 million forcibly displaced Myanmar nationals, FDMNS, have been living in 34 camps in 3,000 shelters on about 2,600 hectares of land in Cox's Bazar. The government of Bangladesh, with the help of UN organizations like UNHCR, IOM, WFP, UNICEF, and national and international NGOs, has been providing food, shelter, education, protection. The government of Bangladesh and a number of humanitarian organizations have been taking care of the health facilities of these densely populated camps. Due to strict precautionary measures, no contagious diseases spread. Alarming to note that nearly 100,000 children were born in the camps since August 2017. Such increase in number of FDMN population will further aggravate the situation. Although the large number of camps and shelters had initially caused extensive damage to the forests and ecosystem, but special efforts are being taken to salvage and restore them. Bangladesh's successful model, Cyclone Preparedness Program, is being implemented to protect this mammoth population in the hilly terrains of disaster-prone Cox's Bazar. Strict adherence to all COVID-19 mitigation protocols and public health guidelines have kept the FDMNS safe. As a result, the rate of infection and death is remarkably low compared to national rate. Prior to the safe and dignified repatriation of Rohingyas, plans are afoot to relocate 100,000 people to a shelter with better facilities at the island of Bhashanchor. 19,000 people have already been voluntarily relocated to Bhashanchor. The Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina, recommends the way out for a long-term solution to this crisis under the auspices of the international community at the 72nd to 75th sessions of the UN General Assembly. The UN Secretary General has sent a fact-finding team to Myanmar in 2017. This submitted its report at the end of the inspection. An agreement on repatriation has signed between Myanmar and Bangladesh in 2017. A permanent solution will be possible if this agreement, the recommendations of the Honorable Prime Minister and the UN delegation report are duly implemented. The international media has bestowed the title Mother of Humanity upon Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina. She has also been awarded with two prestigious international awards, IPS International Achievement Award and the 2018 Special Distinction Award, for her great leadership, humanitarian initiatives, and prudent policies. Repatriation is the only solution of this FDMN's crisis. But Myanmar's little interest for repatriation drives the FDMNs towards uncertainties and disappointment. Bangladesh's call and expectation to the international community to come forward and take immediate steps so that Myanmar will ensure a conducive environment for the safe, sustainable, and dignified return of the Rohingyas.